He's sitting on a swing right now, but he keeps pulling it in and out of his pants.
Timothy Lohman, the officer who shot and killed Tamir Rice November 22nd outside the Cadell Recreation Center, told a fellow officer moments after the shooting that he felt Tamir gave him no choice, saying the 12-year-old reached for a gun seconds before he was shot. Lohman's reaction was detailed in a 224-page sheriff's investigation released Saturday by Cuyahoga County Prosecutor Timothy McGinty. The report was viewed Friday by Tamir's mother and attorneys, who are hoping for criminal charges to be filed by prosecutors.
My goal is to get justice. I'm seeking justice.
We're very hopeful that they're going to do a vigorous prosecution because we think this was a horrible, horrible tragedy that never should have happened. That young child should have never been shot. And that's very clear.
We're hoping and we're still seeking justice.
McGinty released a statement saying he released the report because he believes transparency is essential for an intelligent discussion of the important issues raised in this case. The officers involved in the shooting, as well as Samaria Rice, Tamir Rice's mother, declined to speak with detectives about the investigation. The sheriff's department's report also included a statement from an FBI agent who arrived to the scene moments after the shooting. The agent said the Cleveland officers did not have a first aid kit or training. He said he began first aid and said Tamir mumbled something about a gun and also took the agent's hand. Rice had an airsoft pistol that police said looked like a real gun. He died the following day at the hospital.
It's completely inappropriate. It's
Steve Loomis, president of the police union, says the case is a tragedy, but he does not believe the sheriff's report should have been released until the grand jury had time to review it.
It's not something that we want to happen, but at the end of the day, when somebody pulls a gun out of their waistband, whether it's a replica gun or a real gun, in front of Cleveland police officers, they're duty-bound to take some type of action, and that's why we're here.
Prosecutors say they will now review the report and then present it to the grand jury to determine if any criminal charges should be filed. In Cleveland, Peggy Gallick, Fox 8 News.